So outwards you become witness, sakshi. Sakshi of what? Body. Okay. Just keep observing the body, not the world. Because body is representative of world. Right? So when any thought comes, just ignore it and continue to observe the body. Okay. So by that process, what happens? Body is it direct experience or indirect experience for you?
Indirect.
Thought is indirect. Right? Reject the thought and continue with the body. Now here let me do an experiment, right? So hold your hand like this and press hard. Okay. So here, what is direct experience, what is indirect experience? Can you separate out? Tell me. What was the direct experience, Sudha? When you did this, what is the direct experience?
The pressure.
The pressure is the direct experience. What is the indirect experience? My hand is here, is mind. You understand? My hand is, I am holding my hand like this. Okay? So that is mind. That's the interpretation. It's not direct experience. It's a thought.
Why is mind not a direct experience?
It's a thought, no? So what are you feeling? What is direct experience now? At this
pressure.
Moment?
Pressure.
At this moment? Pressure. That's all. Thought is coming from the past. There is something called hand and all is also memory. So right now, is there an experience of the hand there?
Sensation.
That is direct.
And physical, see, our mind reading is itself, the sensation is the direct experience. Seeing of that hand is also direct experience. Only that sensation is happening here. That is only indirect experience. Sensation is happening in this place.
Is it direct or indirect?
Indirect.
How is it indirect?
Because mind is only telling that sense is happening.
No, here is also indirect. Sensation is there, that's all.
Besides the location.
The location is just sensation is there, that's all, nothing else.
Sight?
The sight is actually mind saying there is a space around that. Space is not your direct experience, no?
Space is also experience. Space.
Space is experienced with respect to an object. So there is a experience here. My body is a direct experience or indirect experience for you?
Direct.
My body is indirect. It's a concept.
For you, the experience is there is a sensation. Body is nothing but sensation. It is my body is an interpretation.
Thought.
What is it?
A thought is always the
interpretation. Just go to the direct experience. Okay, mind will interpret. Oh, there's a leg pain in my body, there's a stomach pain. There's a stomach pain character. But my body, the pain says it's your body, is it? Pain is the interpretation.
No, pain is the direct.
No, sensation is direct. Pain is also interpreted by the mind.
Classify it as pain.
Okay. If you gradually start observing the direct experience, this concept of pain and pressure, everything will go. You experience the life in raw form, direct experience. Okay. So in direct experience, you start gradually realizing that there is no body. Just nothing but.
So that is a question.
And where is the sensation? Where is the sensation? Can you tell me? Where is the sensation?
Brain.
Where is the sensation?
We can't say
conscious.
It is just floating in my awareness, that's all. I can't even say where. So if you close your eyes and experience the body, there is a sensation floating in your awareness. Oh, my body, this is here, it's all interpretation happening by the mind. That mind is Maya. It's lot of interpretation happens.
Can't even say sensation is here. It's just floating.
Just floating. Are you understanding what I'm saying? The moment you say, I am observing my body, then you are not doing vipassana. This is what people do mistake in vipassana. You understand? Are you getting what I'm saying? There is a pain in my back, you have already interpreted it. There is a sensation, okay?
Already distorted.
So, straight observe the sensation. Now, as you observe the sensation very carefully, the sensation itself will become minute. Okay? Then you start seeing that there is no sensation. Then you see, it's atoms, molecules, then waves. The body. Now the body dissolves and comes back again. But what has happened to you is in your mind, there is a solid body, solid, and I am the solid body, starts getting
erased.
Are you clear? What, Surya? Right? So what you are trying to do is every time you do this, every time you do this thing, the Sahaja Samadhi, one that, what you guys, who am I, Koham. So what you are doing, I am not the body, I am not the mind, you don't have to say, already you are becoming awareness. Already new identities, awareness, I am awareness is coming. Okay? So by looking at the body sensations, you are already recognizing that body is nothing but solid, it is just nothing but atoms and molecules, just a vibration. So not the body, two parts. Not the body, one is Bahya and it's Antar. Right? Samadhi is two, Sahaja Samadhi is two types. Bahya Samadhi, Antar Samadhi. Are you clear? So, is it clear? So first you start observing the breath. Okay? When you observe the breath, you observe the sensations at this point. So, small touch happens here at this point. This point is important. Okay? Because our in the mother's womb, two cells came together. They became four, eight. Okay. The nature, like a builder requires a marker, right? To where to start, put a boundary. The nature has put a marker here. You can see. This is the marker put nature to a center point. It wants the Prakriti, Jagan Mata, to build your body. That's why this is useless point, useless, two marks. But they are beginning point for building your body. Understand? So now, if you observe the sensation here, what happens, when the nature started building your body, so those, it starts from that, all the body start feeling, vibrations will start coming up. When your mother's womb started building the body, layer by layer, so that sensations will start coming up. So you start observing that from head to toe. Okay, as you start observing head to toe, gradually that becomes deeper and deeper. Thoughts will come, mind will drift, again come back to sensation. Okay, feel from all part of the body. The sensation becomes subtler and subtler and subtler, and you start feeling the body is slowly dissolving. Are you clear? You'll start? So now,
when we observe the breath, attention must be here. But go to the body sensation.
Your body you scan, no?
Scan.
Okay, you think scanning is like this, okay? There is a robot, okay? A robot wants to create your image. It takes laser beam and scans, and it goes into the computer, right? Like that, your attention has to go from scanning, head to toe, toe to head, again and again. It's like a laser beam. You understand what I'm saying?
Yes, sir. Breath time, breath awareness.
First, you focus on the breath for some time.
Huh.
Yeah.
Not breath. Okay. Not breath.
Oh, yeah. This point.
No, no. Mm. Yeah.
These two lines.
At that point. Mm. Yeah, there you should feel it, not the breath touching, slowly, gently.
One tingling sense.
Tingling sensation will come.
Sensation.
Then you start scanning the body. Because then otherwise you cannot feel the body immediately. So it's like you can imagine the scanning the body is like laser gun. You are just mapping the body. So the robot. So then what will happen? That body image will be created in the computer. Right? You understand what I'm saying?
Yes.
Like that, by scanning your body, your mental map of solid body is replaced with now ... It's no longer solid now. Are you getting? శరీరుడు. అబ్జర్వ్ యువర్ బ్రెత్. Become aware of the breath at the upper lip to the nose bridge. You may start feeling a tingling sensation there. Then you start scanning your body from head to toe, every part of the body, inch by inch. You may feel small vibrations, small sensations. Sometimes there is no sensation also, but continue, keep scanning so that the body image has to be really established in the mind, right image, real image. Any thought comes, just drop it. Understand that the body is nothing but a sensation floating in awareness. Asatoma,
Asatoma,
Sadgamaya,
Sadgamaya,
Tamasoma,
Tamasoma,
Jyotirgamaya,
Jyotirgamaya,
Mrityorma,
Mrityorma,
Amritamgamaya,
Amritamgamaya.
Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti.
Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti.
लोकाः समस्ताः
लोकाः समस्ताः
सुखिनो भवन्तु
सुखिनो भवन्तु
लोकाः समस्ताः
लोकाः समस्ताः
सुखिनो भवन्तु
सुखिनो भवन्तु
लोकाः समस्ताः
लोकाः समस्ताः
सुखिनो भवन्तु
सुखिनो भवन्तु
हरिः ओम
हरिः ओम
श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः
श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः
हरिः ओम
हरिः ओम
So you are doing only one practice, okay? Sahaja Samadhi, which is Bahya and Antar. Bahya means remain witness to the body. Antar means who am I? Awareness. So this combination.
Am I aware?
Am I aware?
I am.
Huh?
I am.
I am. First you go to I am. Stay there.
And then am I aware?
Am I aware? Okay? So this is the complete package. I am not the body, I am not the mind, I am not the intellect. I am pure consciousness. So this Sahaja Samadhi practice is a total practice.